of color that is critical that a lot of people, that's where I think when portfolios are shown and people have not had that background, that's where it all kind of goes, you know, yeah, awry, exactly. So think about color. Don't do work on color anymore. Color is easy. Go to cooler. Cooler's so great because what you'll do is you could actually take a, do you mind if I grab this for a second? If you like the look of this, you literally can scan this in and it will take it into Illustrator and it will extract every single color on here for you. And then give you a color palette. How great is that? Okay, if we have time at the end, we'll just kind of go to that page in a sec. But that's one thing it can do. And it can take things from nature. You can bring a leaf in here and it can take all the color from the leaf. I mean, it's just so great. But what's even more profound, I mean, that is pretty profound, but what's really quick, let's say, is that you actually can go on there and type, well, you can say, well, I want my book to feel like, and again, we're talking tone, because you want to know, what is the tone of your book? Is it happy? Is it uplifting? Is it businesslike? Is it sophisticated? Is it playful? You know, what kind of, you know, tone are you trying to project? And maybe you don't know all the colors that project that type of tone. So let's just say, if you're trying to do something that was, I don't know, you could say romantic, right, then it probably will pull up all the romantic colors, like the purples and the light pinks and these wonderful teal greens and things of that sort. It'll give you the whole panel. And then you pick. And then you can say, I like that particular color palette, and then you could literally incorporate that right into Illustrator. Pretty amazing, you guys. And that's one of the shortcuts that we use in the business, because we don't have time to work around color. Because time really is money in the business, right? So, cooler really works. Okay, so, those two are very important, okay, line, color, shape. Shape is important in terms of on your page. You know, a lot of times people will design a layout and they forget that, you know, we're seeing shapes on the page. So, I mean, you probably would want to do something, you know, that's kind of like an amoeba, like if it doesn't make any sense, right? So maybe it makes better sense if you want some shapes or some sort just to kind of create, you know, circles or some, of some sort. So think about what it is you're doing. Like, you don't want to just create a shape that's meaningless. You want a shape that means something. Okay? When we do shapes, shapes also have meaning. So if I did a circle is softer, kinder, friendlier than a square. Right? So everything has a meaning. So when you're thinking about visual thinking, everything has a meaning. Why did you choose that shape? You know, why did you choose that color? And the other thing is, I'm going to tie that into repetition and rhythm, because oftentimes if you see a circle in your logo, let's say, then more than likely you want to carry a circle throughout the entire book. If you have a square, carry a square or sharper line throughout the entire book. And that's one of those little things people don't know, but people that have been trained, we know, looking at it, that, you know, it could flow better if there were consistency in the circles or shapes that you chose. Okay? And just the one thing is, you never want to choose that afterthought shape, that amoeba. Okay? All right, so, the thing about shape, we think about space. Space is very important too. And what happens with space, these are the issues that I think are usually problems, is some people would design like this, and then they would design like this, and then they would do the same thing here, and then yet this image is all the way over here. Do you see? So this little bit of space should be the same little bit of space there in most cases. Okay, because you're trying to look for consistency and flow. Okay, there's a guy named Setsa Mahaly who actually talks about flow. He's a psychologist, but you have to have flow in everything, especially in your designs. If you don't have flow, there's all these big gaps and spaces and all this stuff, and you won't have flow and people will never make it past page 5. Okay, or you've lost them and you don't even know you've lost them. Okay, so keep it simple. What I love nowadays that did not exist previously is templates. You guys use templates, why not? Okay, you have no reason not to use a template. Nobody's grading you guys from the standpoint of design, okay, from the standpoint of design as a, nobody's looking for you to design a whole layout. Okay, it's just like with my students, they do the layout in their actual books, but one thing they're not really knowledgeable of is website development. That's not their area. They didn't get all the training they needed. So I do have them use, you know, the website templates, and all they have to do is drop and go, drop and go, drop and go. And that's going to make for a nice, clean book, okay? So templates. And guess what? You can always just type in templates whenever you're doing any search, and they all pop up. That's a key word, the magic word that a lot of people forget is templates. You can even put templates of in quotes, and it'll come up even quicker. Okay? All right, so we get unity in that way, so things are unified and so on. Harmony, it presents harmony, balance, rhythm. Contrast is really important from the standpoint of, there's a couple ways to approach contrast in that Contrast is the dark against the light. I see sometimes in portfolios, people will do a really light campaign, and next to it is a really dark campaign. And when you look through the book, you're like, right? Or something fluorescent pops out. You're like, what? You know, you did pastel next to fluorescent, really? You know, so you can see that. Most of these things we can all see. So you just stop and go through your book. When something doesn't feel right, you're probably right. There's something wrong. You've got to just kind of go back and say, why doesn't this feel right? Is it the color? Is it the line? Is it the what? Okay, and ask your peers, okay? So the other thing I've seen in terms of contrast issues is that sometimes campaigns that are very different, like let's say you have something really edgy, and then you take them to something that's really soft and just really stagnant. You have to make sure that the kind of, the two people, two campaigns on each page are kind of similar, or it kind of flows into the next one. You don't want something that's like screaming like, this belongs in Europe and this belongs in Idaho, right? Okay, small town, basically. So that's what you want to do, is think about that.